Okay.
Yes. I want to welcome everybody here to Kol Shira. Thank you for attending. And we learn the Lakuta Halachas, Baruch Hashem, and we're in the middle of learning Hilchas Beit Haknesset. And it's such an appropriate thing to learn these days, especially because we're in the 3 weeks, and the whole idea of the Churban Beis HaMikdash. And if we learn about the Kedusha of the Beis HaKnesses, we know that a Beis HaKnesses is really a Mikdash Ma'at, right? It's a Mikdash Ma'at. So how can we work on increasing the Kedusha that we have and the importance of the Beis, but the Midrashim that we have? So let's learn a little bit about it. Here we go. Says the Rebbe, Inyan Kedusha's Beis HaKnesses, Bishat Tashmishe Kedusha. So the idea of the Kedusha of the Beis HaKnesses, right? So you have a Beis HaKnesses, a Makim Kodesh, right? What is Kedusha? What is the word? When you say something is Kodesh, what does that mean? That means it's separated from everything else of the world. It's separated. It's separated. For example, a person wants to marry a lady. So he says, Hareyat mekudeshes li b'tabazu, kedas ma'ishav Yisrael. When he does that, he's saying that this lady now is separated from the rest of the world. It's now she's his, and she can't be with anybody else. That's what Kedusha is. Kedusha is separation. V'shar tashmishi kedusha. And other things that we use for tashmishi kedusha, right? So like when we have a tefillin bag, and we have the different things that we use for kedusha, tashmishi kedusha. V'chol eilu advarim shebekedusha tluyim b'das adam. Everything is totally is dependent on the das, the knowledge, the intent of the person, right? So in other words, you could take people buy a home, and they'll say, I want to make this home into a shul, right? Dr. Smile, you did that, right? You turned your home into a Beit HaKnesses, right? So by doing that, that was totally in your das. You decided that you want to make this into a shul, right? Is that what happened?
Yes.
Via you deciding to make it into a shul. That's what made it have the kedusha of the shul, because you decided to do that.
Yes.
So it's totally in the das. Okay, now. Tulim b'das adam. Ukishemaz min adover l'tashmish kedusha. And when you are mezamen, you prepare, you separate it, you are mazmin it, you invite it, right? Like mazmin, right? And you have it, and you're going to use this for kedusha. Umishtamish by lidavishik kedusha, and you use it for something of kedusha. Hazayin is kadesh. So then it has it gains the level of kedusha to it, because you used it, you decided to use it, and then you used it for kedusha. So then it gets the level of holiness. How does something get the level of holiness? You need to have intent. You need to think about that you want to make this part of something holy. And at the same time, what you want to do is, you have to use it for something of Kedusha. So, if you prepared something, but you don't use it for Kedusha, or you use something for Kedusha, but you didn't think about using it for Kedusha, it doesn't have the level of Kedusha. There's no Chal Kedusha. Rak azamne v'tzarbe. But if you prepared it, azamne, in other words, you prepared, you thought about using it, and you use it, oz Chal Kedusha v'osu lohitziya l'chulin, and then you can't take it out and use it for chulin. Right, for example, you take a table for like a bima in the shul, right? So the table that you use in the shul for the bima, it can be any table. Now I say, I'm going to take this table, and I'm designating this table to be the shulchan here in the base medrash, right? To be the omid. And then you use it for the shulchan. So then what you did was you affixed kedusha in that shulchan, because you used it and you intended to use it for kedusha. Nimsa. Shetashmishe kedusha kedushasam chala yedei adam. So you find out here, really what gains kedusha to it is really dependent on the person, right? Dependent on the person. Someone has they have leather, right? In a tannery, they have leather, right? So now, you can make with leather. You can make chairs with leather. You can make a coat with leather. But if a sofer, if a batimacher comes in, the one that makes the batim for the tefillin, and he said, decides this leather, I'm using this to make tefillin. I'm using this to make the cloth for a sefer Torah. I'm using this to make the cloth for the mezuzahs. By him designating it to make it for that, that's what puts the kedusha on the thing. When he uses it and he actually writes on it. Do you understand how it works? In other words, you have to have both das and you have to use it. If you have one without the other, it doesn't work. You can intend on something to be kaddish, in like a shulchan or something else, but if you don't actually use it, it doesn't have, it's not chal on it.
Amen.
The kedusha is chal because the person designated it for the kedusha. V'chein kedusha is beis haknesses. Hakol toli b'shiva tiva ya'ir. The seven leaders of the community. You have seven leaders, seven the president, and the bagabei tzedaka, and the seven leaders. K'mavoy b'shulchan aruch, and you can look that up in Simen Kuf Nun Gimel Sif Zayin. Now. Kisa b'divrei Rabbeinu Zal she'ik kedushas Eretz Yisrael hu ayidei b'chinas koyach masav higid liyamai.
Okay, what's up?
Kedusha of Eretz Yisrael is dependent on what? Hu ayidei b'chinas koyach masav higid liyamai. The koyach of the masav of Hashem, the actions of Hashem, higid liyamai will be told over to the people. Is higid liyamai. With the ratzon of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem gave Eretz Yisrael to the Canaanim originally, right? Eretz Yisrael belonged to the Canaanim because Hashem gave it to them. But Hashem took Eretz Yisrael from the Canaanim, and He gave it to Klal Yisrael. Oh no, the Ratzon of Hashem was originally that the Knanim should be living in Eretz Yisrael. And with HaKadosh Baruch Hu also, that's the first Rashi in Chumash, right? He gave it to us. Eretz Yisrael was given to us. It's our land. Amazing. Now, Ayin Sham, Mavaya Sham, B'divrei Rabbeinu Zal, Ala Pasik V'Shanan, שזה בחינס כל המקיימי שבקדושה שישראל קייפשם לפעמים, איזה מקיימ מקדישם איזה בקדושה שישראל. See, when a community gets together, yeah, and they decide we need to build a shul, so they have to be kaivish, they have to sort of say conquer it from the side of impurity and take it back and make it into kedusha. In other words, people have to. Do you understand what's going on? In other words, a community decides that they want to make a new shul, they want to make a new base medrash, make a new yeshiva. Now, if they're in chutz laretz, right? So then they have to take that land that belongs to the Goyim, purchase it, and then convince them to turn that into something of Kedusha. In other words, to take it away from the side of the Goyim and bring it into Klal Yisrael. And to have Kedusha Yisrael. But they're able to say, hey, you stole it from us. They do that today, right? They're doing that today, right? List them out them, right? You stole it from us. It's our land. You stole it from us. Ach, ayadei koyach masav, higid liyamai. But from the koyach of the masav, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, higid liyamai, it'll be told over. See, that's the whole problem. See, when we're in Eretz Yisrael, and we're wherever we are, and we're doing the right thing, we're following the Torah, we're following Torah's Moshe, we're following the dinim of Shulchan Aruch, by us doing that, that proves that it's our land. But if we're in the land, and we're not doing what we're supposed to do, Chas V'Shalom, so then They have the right to say, listen, Atem, what right do you have to this land? You're not using it for what it was intended for. So we want to take it back. And through that, we have the power to conquer the world. How do we do that? Via Torah mitzvahs. We can be conquer the world. Anytime we want. If we want to do the right thing, we have the right intent, and we do it for the right thing. Again, it's totally on what? Our intent and our actions. So if we have the intent that we're going to use this building that we're going to build, we're going to use this as a yeshiva, we're going to use this as a base medrash, we're going to use this as a mikvah, whatever we're going to use it for, but we're going to use it from via that, by us actually doing it. That's what affixes the Kedusha in that place. Kibret Sinai Nasna Lahem, because it was the original Ratzon that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave it to them, over at Sinai Nasna Lahem, but Nasna Lanu, he gave it to us. Now, this is what it means, the Kedusha of the Beis HaKnesses. Kiyika Kedusha's Beis HaKnesses, who are Yedei Bechinas Kayach Masav, Higli Yamai. Sha Yedei Zeh Yesh Lanu Kayach Likadesh Kol HaMekayim Shebo'ilam. By us again, having in mind, we have the right kavana that we're trying to make this into a shul. We're trying to make this into a yeshiva. By us doing that, that's how we can conquer the world. Ki Hashem Yisbarach Bara Hakol, because Hashem made everything. He created everything. Over Tzaynay Nasna Lanu, and He gave it to us when we're doing the right thing. Hashem wants us to have it. And that's what it means, the Kedusha of Eretz Yisrael. In other words, when we're set aside, what is Kedusha? Set aside. So there's the whole world does everything like this. No, but we follow the Torah. We do things the way we're supposed to. Not Chas Shalom, the way that they're trying to do sometimes. And they're trying to be, want to be like the rest of the world. No, we don't want to be like the rest of the world. When we try to be like the rest of the world says, you stole our land. But if we're doing the right thing and we're following the Torah and we're saying, you do what you do, but we have to do what we have to do, then the Kedusha is when we're affixing the Kedusha in Eretz Yisrael, and then Eretz Yisrael, no one can say, list them out them. But Chas V'Shalom, when we don't do that, then they can keep saying, list them out them, you're robbers. Zeh Bechinas Kedusha Eretz Yisrael. Ki gam Kedusha Beis HaKnesses, hu Bechinas Kedusha Eretz Yisrael. We know that all of the shuls and all of the batei midrashim, it's Hashem, when Mashiach comes, are going to be affixed, come to Eretz Yisrael, right? Because we know that every shul and every base medrash is a migdash ma'at, right? The Navi teaches us that, right? That it's a migdash ma'at. What does a migdash ma'at mean? It's a small migdash. It's like a small migdash. And a migdash has the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael. So when you're in a shul, you're in a base medrash that again was built for the right reason. So that has the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael in it. It's amazing. The Navi Yecheskel says, the Navi Yecheskel taught us this idea of Migdash Ma'at, that it's a Migdash Ma'at. Ilu batei kinesias batei midrashes. Chazal teach us what the Navi Yecheskel was saying. Migdash Ma'at is talking about the batei midrashes and the batei kinesias. K'may shamar b'sein nazal. Zeh b'chines Migdash Hashem k'inu yadecha. Sheikah kedushas ha-migdash Shazel Bechinas Beis HaKnesses Beis HaMidrash. The whole idea of the Kedusha of the Beis of the Kedusha of the Migdash, the Holy Migdash that stood on Har HaBayis. Shazel Bechinas Beis HaKnesses Beis HaMidrash. Hu Al Yedei Bechinas Yadayim? Yadayim Sheyesh Bohem Koyach. Al Yadayim have Koyach. What's Koyach? Power, might. Power, Koyach, right? But let me ask you something, Dr. Smith. In your right hand, how many joints do you have? How many joints are there in the right hand?
200.
No, joints. One, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
14
joints. 14 joints in the hand. And in your left hand, how many do you have?
14.
Okay, 14 and 14 is how much?
28.
And koyach, the word koach, kof and a ches,
28.
Wow. Su yedeichem kodesh uvorchu es Hashem. You lift up your hands. Su yedeichem kodesh uvorchu es Hashem. Koyach. Koyach. You go look what he says. Look at this, my yedayim. Sheyesh behem chof ches esrim ushmoina pirkin. What was that pirkin? Joints. Joints. Shein bechinas koyach masav. The koyach of our action. In other words, we have the koyach by of us doing something. By fixing the kedusha in there, that's the main idea of the base of kedusha, the base of Knesset. When we use it for a kedusha, when we use it to elevate the shechina, when we do it to come closer to Hashem, that's the kedusha of the base of Knesset. And therefore, whenever you have any kind of tashmisha kedusha, anything you use for kedusha. So in other words, you can have a new pair of tzitzis that you didn't put the strings on it yet. So it's nothing. It doesn't have kedusha in it. Oh, when you put the strings on, now it has kedusha to it because you did something. You have to do something. You can have the intent. I buy strings. I buy the beged. I'm going to make it. But it doesn't have the kedusha until you do it. You have to do it. Koyach masa. You have to actually do it. Because when you're mishamish, you're using it, ze bechinas asiyah, that's actually doing something, that's an asiyah, it's an action. Bechinas yadayim, and how do you do actions? You use your hands. Again, kaf ches, which is 28, Koyach masav higid liyamai, right? V'zeh daika chala b'kedusha. Ki ikar mashin imtsuch kedusha, because the main point of drawing kedusha, ala davar hum b'chinas koyach masav, is by the koyach of masav. Again, the chav ches, 28. Shemiksham nimtsuch kedusha z'eret Yisrael, and that's how you get the kedusha z'eret Yisrael. Z'eh b'chinas yedayim b'chinas chav ches perkin. Now, v'alkein, b'inyan azam neitzar bei, so we learned that you have to have the right machshava, right? And you have to have maisa. Machshava and maisa. You have to have machshava and maisa, right here. Ki shavrit ha-kedusha hu b'machshava, because the shavrit ha-kedusha is in our intent, our machshava, what we think, the machshava. Ki ha-machshava hu b'chinas chachma, because machshava is chachma. Thought is chachma. Bechin is kodesh, which is kodesh, like we said, is designated, separated from something else. Kamuva aval ikar, ikar shleimus hakedusha hu. Next page, please. Shakedusha nimsheches biyadayim v'bechinas uvda. When the kedusha is nimshech biyadayim, so you have the machshava, but now you're drawing it in. You're drawing the machshav, you're turning it into an action. The uvda, the action. V'zeh ikar ma'alas u'shleimus ha'kedusha shemekashrin ha'uvda v'asiyah el ha'kedusha. When you take your action and you do it for kedusha, that's how you get, that's how you bring kedusha into it. By taking the action, thinking about it, and then doing it, that's how you affix the kedusha on it. V'v'chines su yedeichem kodesh. Lift up your hands to be kedusha by doing actions of kedusha. Sheikah shleimus hakedusha hu b'yadayim, because the main shleimus, the completion of the kedusha. How do you complete and have kedusha shleimus of the kedusha hu b'yadayim? Shesham ikra kedusha, because in your hands is the ikra kedusha, and that's why we know in the morning when you get up in the morning you have to wash your hands, right? Because the tumah rests on the yadayim, right? Chazal teach us. But then when you wash your hands the right way, you wash one. That's the remedy to take the tumah off. So we know that the kedusha is really in our hands. And that's why it's so important to always keep the hands clean and use the hands for the right thing, right? Again, through the hands is the main point of Kedusha. That's the completion of kedusha. Kiika shleimus kedusha shnimtzach kedusha gam b'madrega tachtaina. In other words, you could take it even in a low, low level. In other words, you could take kedusha, take something very low, and you could elevate it up to kedusha by using your hands, by using it for something special. B'chinas asiyah by doing it. Now, is there b'chinas kol tashmisha kedusha chala kedusha sam taika yedei machshava v'ovda. So again, just to review. So in other words, you're only going to get the kedusha into something when you have both machshava, you think I want this to be holy, and then you do an action to make it holy. You need those two things. Dainu azamne vitzarbe. I prepare it, and the vitzarbe, and I use it, then I have the kedusha. Aval azamna levad. But if I prepare it alone, v'lav milsu, I didn't do anything actually to it. So again, it's not enough that you just have intent. We have to do something. We can have in mind in the morning, where I want to put on my tefillin, but I have to actually put it on. Having in mind that I want to do something is nice, but if I don't actually do it, what did I accomplish? In other words, when you want to fix kedusha to something, you have to have in mind to do it, and you have to do it. You need machshava and you need asiyah. Because the main thing is, anytime you fix kedusha on something, you're connecting to the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael. The same way the Beis Haknesset and the Beis Medrash is connected to the kedusha as a mikdash ma'at. Is a mikdash ma'at, which is connected to the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael. V'ika kedusha Eretz Yisrael hu b'chinas kayach ma'asav. That we know Shashem is Boris that we know clearly that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world with his Ratzon exactly the way Hashem wanted everything in the world. That's the way it is in the world. It's all HaKadosh Baruch Hu's Ratzon. And it was the Ratzon HaKadosh Baruch Hu took the Eretz Yisrael, the Holy Land, from the Canaanim. He took it from the Canaanim and he gave it to us. You know, I saw a beautiful shot. Why does it say that? Why is it called? Why are they called Canaanim? Why were they called Canaanim? From Hachna, from the word Hachna. Someone has to put himself down. We keep ourselves as people of Hachna. We don't feel it's b'kayich of oitzim yodi asali esachayil azeh, but we feel it's all me'es Hashem. So then that's the greatest remedy to keep Eretz Yisrael when we have Hachna. So that HaKadosh Baruch Hu had the Knanim there to teach us that we have to have Hachna in order to keep Eretz Yisrael. When we know that everything is Hashem's, when we understand it's all HaKadosh Baruch Hu's and it's His ruts and exactly the way things happen. Hashem is Baruch. Baruch Hu Nikra Kadosh, because we know Kadosh Baruch Hu is called Kadosh. Hashem is holy. V'tekev k'shiyoydim Hashem is Baruch Hadavar. And as soon as we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu made the thing, as soon as we understand that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is Kadosh, and we understand when Hashem made that thing, nimtzach l'sham kedusha. In other words, we draw from HaKadosh Baruch Hu's kedusha. We draw kedusha to the item, to the place that we understand that Hashem made it, and it's Hashem's. We draw kedusha to it because we're drawing from HaKadosh Baruch Hu's ultimate kedusha, unlimited kedusha. V'ikar malas hayadiyah hu kishiyoydim boilam asiyah hagashmi mikdushasa yizbarach. When we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is holy and HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants us to emulate the things He does. HaKadosh Baruch Hu says ma'u racham af ata racham. The same way HaKadosh Baruch Hu acts in a way of Rachmanis, He wants us to act in Rachmanis. Because again, if we act in the way of Rachmanis because that's the way Hashem does it, we affix more kedusha upon ourselves. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is mitzamtzim, He constricted His Kedusha. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is kulei Kadosh. So if HaKadosh Baruch Hu would have had all Kedusha in the world, only Kedusha, the world wouldn't exist. But HaKadosh Baruch Hu had to make, He made a vacuum, He made an idea of tzimtzum, of constriction, in order to allow for creation that it could be Bechira. Al kein es alim kedusha. So therefore, Kadosh Baruch Hu hides his kedusha. He hides his kedusha in the world. Ad sheyesh koyach livchok bekedusha oy lehet bechatz v'shalom. Until a person can choose to be kadosh like Hashem, or he can choose the other way, chatz v'shalom. Like unfortunately, so many people do. They pick the things that they shouldn't. Therefore, the main point in the mal of kedusha is when we sanctify the world of asiya. And then again, how do we do that? We have to have the right machshava. And what's the machshava? To understand that Hashem was the one that created it. And the same way, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is malei kedusha, is the ultimate kedusha. And if we understand that Hashem created it, so then we connect to the kedusha of HaKadosh Baruch Hu in that thing by us having the machshava that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the one that created it. The 28 joints. So from the leaders of the community, they are the heads of the community, right? The Tuvei Ha'ir. And they are the Roish Bechinas HaMaychen. Shemisham Shairit Gedushba. Okay, Nikrin Tuvei Ha'ir, Lashon Toiv. They're called the Tuvei Ha'ir. Why? The Lashon of Toiv of goodness. The Tuvei Ha'ir called Tuvei Ha'ir from the Lashon of Toiv. Ki Das V'Amayach U'Bechinas Toiv. Because when the person has Das, and he uses his mind for Kedusha, that's Toiv. Gam b'loy das nefesh loy toiv. In Mishlei, gam b'loy das b'das nefesh loy toiv. If a person has b'loy das, if you have loy das, nefesh loy toiv. If you have no das, then the nefesh is loy toiv. Nefesh is loy toiv. Kamuv b'divrei Rabbeinu Zal. Izeh b'chinas kedushas Eretz Yisrael. B'chinas ha'har ha'toiv azeh v'alvonan. As we say, it's in Devarim Gimel, it's coming up in another 2 weeks, right? Hahar HaToiv, this good mountain, Hazev HaLevonon, right? Ki Shiva Tuvei Ha'ir, Bahem Tuliyah Kedushas Beis HaKnesses, V'chol Tashmish HaKedusha. They are the ones that decide what the Beis HaKnesses will have, and the Minhagim of the Beis HaKnesses, and the ideas of what's going to happen in the Beis HaKnesses is all based on the Tuvei Ha'ir, the leaders of the community. Shein Bechinas Kedushas Eretz Yisrael, Gam Heim Misaknim Takonis Yisharois. They set up nice ideas, Takonis Yisharois. They set up ordinances. They set it up that are Yoshar Umidarkin Esa'am Umadrichin Esa'am Bederech HaToiv. And they hopefully lead us in the way of goodness. VaYoshar Bederech Eretz, to teach us how to do the things the right way. Kiyei Manhigim Esa'olam. That they try to run the world in a way that no one should go out of the line, that straight line, the shura. And no one should do chas v'shalom something wrong to their friend, chas v'shalom. Everyone should run their lives and do things in the right, proper way. That's the kedusha of Yisrael. Bechinas derech eretz. That's derech eretz. In the Maimar of Eschanan from Rabbi Nachman. Al Kain. Nikroyim Shiva Tuvei Ha'ir. That's why they're called the Tuvei Ha'ir. Lashon Toiv. Shul bechinas meichin. Toiv is good, like we saw in Mishlei. If you have toiv, if you have das, so then your nefesh is toiv. But if there's no das, then the nefesh is loy toiv. Okay, so it's also like zahara toiv. Alkein, therefore, shiva tuvei ha'ir, the seven leaders of the community. The seven leaders of the community, hey, mamshich and kedusha Eretz Yisrael b'chol advarim shebe kedusha. They draw the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael in everything of kedusha in the base of Knesset and the base of Medrash. Umaytzia naisam b'chinas shiva amimin, and they take it away from the seven nations that were in Eretz Yisrael. So I said it's so betchila biyadam was in the lands of the seven nations, right? The Amayri, Achizi, Apuzi, Vavusi, Vagotri, right? He called Advarim, Mechala Makayme, Srikin, the Kaddish, Bekdushas, Eretz Yisrael. All the places we have to work on being Mekaddish them. In other words, to realize that HaKaddish Baruch Hu was the one that made this land. HaKaddish Baruch Hu gave it to them, and HaKaddish Baruch Hu took it from them, and He gave it to us. That's the main point, is our Das, the Machshova, and the Asiya. And if we have to take it away from them, from the Shiva Amim, that's why there were seven nations, that's why there are seven community leaders. You need one community leader to take down one nation, one for each of the seven nations that were in Eretz Yisrael. Lachnia Shiva Amim, to subdue the seven nations that were there. Lakadish Kolad Varim, Shem Tashmisha Kedusha, to sanctify all of the different ideas, the different things, and the Tashmisha Kedusha V'chein Batei Knesset, the Batei Midrashis, B'Kedushas Eretz Yisrael, to make the Batei Midrashis and the Batei Knesset, like we learned, it's a Migdash Ma'at, is connected to Eretz Yisrael, because again, when you have in mind to build a base of Knesset, a base of Medrash, and you have in mind to use it in the proper way, according to Allah, according to what Chazal taught us to do, b'china sahara toiv, so then it fixes the Kiddush on it. Ki b'chol advarim shabaylam ne'lam, b'yam Kiddusha, d'haynu chiyas elikos. In all things of the world, the Kiddusha is hidden. You have to find the Kiddusha in the world. וזה בחינס התורה הנלמס שהיה מקיים הסוילם כלי דמת התורה. We know the world runs on the Torah, right? But before Matan Torah, how was the world running? How was the world running before Matan Torah? It was hidden. The Torah was hidden. We didn't have the Torah. So what happened? Bechinas derech eretz shekadam l'tayra. See, you have to have derech eretz kadma l'tayra. You have to have derech eretz kadma l'tayra. Shezeh bechinas haderech l'eretz Yisrael. That's the way to Eretz Yisrael. You have to do things in the proper way. Derech eretz is parnasa. Derech eretz is to do things in the right way, to realize that HaKadosh Baruch Hu provides for us. It's not nothing that we're doing. It's not our wisdom that gets us what we want. HaKadosh Baruch Hu can give us parnasa here. He can give us parnasa in Israel. He can give us parnasa anywhere we are in the world. It doesn't matter where we are. If Hashem wants us to have parnasa, we'll have parnasa. Finished. Kamavaya calls a hate to Bimama now, Al Yedei Bechinazu, Taika, Yechoylem Lekadesh, Kol Advarim Shaboylem Velasseis Michol Lekadesh. So in other words, as long as you understand this concept, that you need to have the right machshava, and you need to do an asiyah of kedusha. You have to do something in action to sanctify it. You can make anything you want in the world. You can work on anything and turn things from michal lekodesh. Keep going. Kol advarim shel kedusha ay batei kinesias ay batei midrashos shebetchila hayachal choil gomer. See the house before you made it into Beis HaKnesset was a regular house. It's nothing. It has nothing to do with it. Ah, now you're making a base of Knesset. Oh, now it has a whole new level. It's on a new plateau.
And therefore you bring the Kiddusha to it. Through this idea, the Torah was hidden, and the Torah was hidden, but it was revealed. Bechinas derech eretz, shezeh bechinas koyach masav. Baal Kain, nikra Eretz Yisrael toiv, and therefore Eretz Yisrael is called toiv. It's called good. Why is it called good? Bechinas ahara toiv, the mountain of good. Kik kedusha Eretz Yisrael ayadei bechinas koyach masav. The whole idea of the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael is the koyach masav ayadei shemegalin shashem yisbar bara kol. By us being Megala, by us revealing to the world that Hashem was the one that created it. And we don't have to apologize for anything. HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the land. HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave it to us. We don't need to apologize to anybody. It's HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave it to us. We believe that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave it to us. And we believe it's our land. It's our land. But if we were thinking, well, you know, maybe it's really theirs, this. So then they have a lot of control over us. But as soon as you're going to reveal HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the world, Hu b'chinas ha-toiv, that's toiv. So then Eretz Yisrael also becomes toiv, ha-toiv Hashem. And it says, she-kosov and tilim, toiv Hashem la-kol, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is good for every, is in every aspect possible. And that's what it means, the Kedusha Beis HaKnesses, Kedusha is Eretz Yisrael. And what it means like this, so we really have to come out with this, is like this. Really, when you want to fix Kedusha on something, you have to have the right intent, and you have to have an action. Right? Intent and action. Right? Even when you want to be Mekadosh, a person wants to be Mekadosh, a wife. So what does he have to do? He has to have in mind he wants to be Mekadosh, the lady. But then he has to do an action and say that he wants to be Mekadosh and put the ring on the lady's finger. By the action, brings the Kedusha. He can have in mind all he wants to marry the person, but if he doesn't do anything, nothing happens. But as soon as he does something, the same way a person decides he wants to make a Beis HaKnesses, and he does something for it, by him doing something, that Asiyah is what brings the Kedusha into it. So, Mitzvah Hashem, we should all be Zaycha to realize this idea, to have the right machshavas, and to always do the right actions, and the right actions in order to realize that it's all HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the world. And Hashem made everything, and Hashem is Kadosh. And anytime you realize that Hashem made it in the world, and it's Hashem's doing, the Rebbe teaches us that we're connecting to the Kedusha of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we're allowing the Kedusha of Hashem into this thing. So by us doing that, we connect ourselves to the Kedusha, and we should have a Lech Lecha Shabbos.